So I have this Jacobs spindle nose chuck that I never use with an inch and a half, 8 thread in there. And I found this piece of material that I believe was a stop for a turret lathe. I'm not entirely sure what this was, but it's perfect length and size. I'm going to turn it down to 3/4 to have a 3/4 straight shank for 1.5/8. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the whole thing down to 1.5. I was going to leave a shoulder for the spindle nose chuck to lock up against, but this is actually the side I need to turn down to 3/4 because of this bezel here, and I want to get a full length out of it so I could use it in this boring bar holder. And if I was to use the other end and use this as a shoulder, it would be too short as well. So we'll turn it all down to 1.5. So I decided I'm going to continue to turn this side down for sure to 3/4 inch. So I wanted to get the right stick out for that and make sure I was somewhat close on the indicator, which is... Just over a half thou, or run out. I don't even know if the mill's that good. So once everything is all trued up, I can quickly establish zero using a center in my tailstock. Well, there it is, 3/4 straight shank, 2.5/inch, 8 threads. So I have the capability of using this Jacobs 58B chuck for other uses other than the spindle nose. The surface finish on this came out pretty terrible. The shank was looking really good until the final pass of 6.5 thou, and then on the threads I kept stalling my lathe, and you can see a little gouge right there from one of the stalls where it kind of dove in. I was making extremely small passes, but it was just didn't like that much of a tool engagement. I still am using the plastic PLA 3D printed half nuts on the Atlas, and I'm really impressed with their capabilities. So when I put this in the milling machine, I had just over 1.5 inch of run out, and just over 0.5 thou run out, and I was really impressed with that, but I probably found a sweet spot that everything seemed to have lined up perfectly because I wasn't expecting any tolerances anywhere near that. When I'm in the boring bar holder, I can I have a lot of adjustment of how I can get that all to line up and get aligned with the axis of the lathe. So with that, thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe.